JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for July the 24th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It gained against Aussie, Kiwi, NOK, and slightly against the Canadian dollar, while it underperformed versus the yen, the Swiss franc, and the euro. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the pound and SEK. The strengthening of the safe havens yen and franc, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, suggests that the financial community continued trading in a risk-off fashion. Indeed, although most major EU indices closed virtually unchanged, the US one stumbled on average 1.6%, with the negative investor morale rolling into the Asian session today. Japanese markets stayed closed, but China's Shanghai Composite, Hong Kong's Hang Seng, and South Korea's KO SPI are down 4.13, 2.63, and 1.23% respectively. Following Wednesday's report that the US ordered China to close its consulate in Houston amid accusations of spying, more developments came to add pressure to investors' appetite. Starting with the data, US initial jobless claims accelerated for the first time in nearly 4 months, suggesting that the fast spreading of the coronavirus may have been stalling the economic recovery. On top of that, news hit the wires that Apple faces investigations in several states for deceiving consumers, which steepened Wall Street's slide. Asian shares traded on the back foot as well, with headlines that China ordered the US to close its consulate in Chengdu, adding to the broader negative sentiment. As for our view, we still believe that there are two forces driving the markets recently. On the one hand, hopes that the global economy will recover faster than previously thought, and encouraging headlines over a potential virus vaccine are keeping the latest short-term uptrend in equities and risk-linked assets intact. On the other hand, the heightening tensions between the US and China, combined with the acceleration in global infections from the virus, are resulting in deep downside corrections like the one we had the last couple of days. As we noted yesterday, we still see the case for risk-linked assets to rebound again soon and continue trending north, but the big question remains: for how long can the bulls hold on to the driver's seat? Further escalation in the US-China tensions and the second round of lockdown measures may eventually force more market participants to abandon equities and other risky assets as they seek shelter in safe havens like the dollar, the yen, and the franc. As for today, investors and traders may pay attention to the preliminary PMIs for July. We start the day with the prints from several Eurozone members and the blog as a whole. The Euro Area Manufacturing Index is anticipated to have risen to the equilibrium level of 50 from 47.4, while the services one is expected to reveal expansion for the first time since February. Specifically, it is expected to have increased to 51 from 48.3. The composite index is forecast to have inched up to 51.1 from 48.5. At last week's gathering, the ECB did not alter its monetary policy, but stayed ready to adjust all its instruments as appropriate to ensure that inflation moves towards its aim in a sustained manner. At the press conference following the decision, President Lagarde urged EU governments to take action in battling the coronavirus pandemic as soon as possible, with EU leaders eventually reaching consensus on Tuesday morning. The euro has been on a rally mode this week on hopes that with a fiscal aid, the eurozone is likely to recover faster. Thus, a better than expected set of PMIs could add to those hopes and push the currency even higher, especially against the safe havens USD and JPY, which could come under some selling interest if the data comes on the bright side. Now, as for the rest of today's events, we get the preliminary PMIs from the UK as well, but no forecast is currently available. During the early European morning, we already got the nation's retail sales for June, which came in much better than expected. Thus, combined with this, decent PMIs may diminish expectations with regards to the adoption of negative interest rates by the Bank of England, especially after last week's better than expected inflation and employment data. Having said that, though, the main driver for the pound is likely to be developments surrounding Brexit. Yesterday, EU Chief of Brexit Negotiator Michel Barnier said that the UK has shown no willingness to break the deadlock of talks over a new trade agreement. With just days to go until UK Prime Minister Johnson's deadline for an outline deal, this increases the chances of a no-deal Brexit on December 31st when the transition period ends. Thus, despite the latest recovery in cable, we don't expect the pound to perform well. One reason behind the advance in GBP/USD may have been the weakness in the dollar. We prefer to exploit any potential weakness in the pound against the euro, which we expect to stay supported, especially if today's PMIs surprise to the upside. More PMIs are coming out later in the day, this time from the US. The manufacturing index is expected to have risen to 51.5 from 49.8, while the services one is anticipated to have increased to 51 from 47.9. New home sales for June are also due to be released, with a forecast suggesting a slowdown to 4.4% month over month from 16.6%. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.